I'll be up presently, Archie.
Madame.
You look unhappy, Mr. and Mrs. Cherry. Oh, you must forget the circumstances. Come here and drink some vodka.
I've never tasted vodka before.
Ah, then it is high time. And your friend. I do not know his name.
Oh, Mr. Van. May I present Madame, Madame?
How do you do?
Glad to make your acquaintance, Madame.
You will join us in a glass of vodka?
Thank you.
Three glasses, August.
Yes, Madame.
Please sit down, Mr. Van. I know why you are depressed, Mrs. Cherry. It is the altitude. After the first exhilaration, there comes a depressive reaction. Especially for you, who are accustomed to the heavy pigwiggian atmosphere of England.
Yes. Yes. They what? Just as I thought. Those bombers have gone off on an air raid.
This will be amusing, Gatil.
I hope so.
We none of us like to think that our appearance is commonplace.
The one you look like wasn't commonplace.
Oh, she was someone near and dear to you?
She occupies a unique shrine in the temple of my memory.
Really? That is a glowing tribute. The temple of your memory must be so crowded.
Are you sure you've never been in Omaha, madam?
Omaha. Oh, yes! That is where you said you did what? What was it?
Mind reading.
Of course. No. I'm afraid I do not know your Omaha. But I have seen enough of your countrymen to know that you are typical.
I'm not typical of anything.
Oh, yes, you are. You are an ingenious, sentimental idealist. You believe in the goodness of human nature, don't you?
Well, you can call that sentimental, Mrs. Bebear, but it's true.
Forgive me, but that is not my name.
Oh, well, I thought you
said. I know what you thought. Mr. Bebear and I are associated in a sort of business way.
I see. Business is pretty good.